द प्रिज्म बार कवर टेस्ट PBCT इज एन ऑब्जेक्टिव मेजरमेंट एंड द गोल्ड स्टैंडर्ड इन मेजरिंग स्ट्रैबिस्मस दैट इज ऑकुलर मिस अलाइनमेंट और अ डेविशन ऑफ द आई. इट इज यूज बाई ऑप्टोमेट्रिस्ट, ऑर्थोप्टिस्ट एंड ऑप्थनोलॉजिस्ट इन ऑर्डर टू मेजर द वर्टिकल एंड हॉरिजॉन्टल डेविशन एंड इंक्लूड्स बोथ मैनिफेस्ट एंड लेटेंट कंपोनेंट्स. मैनिफेस्ट इज डिफाइंड बाई द आई डेविएटिंग कॉन्स्टेंटली और इंटरमीडियंटली. Whereas latent is where the deviation is normally controlled but becomes present when the eyes are dissociated. A PBCT reveals the total deviation and cannot distinguish between latent and manifest strabismus as you are using an alternate cover test. Required instruments. A number of different instruments are required when performing a PBCT. Horizontal and vertical prism bar or loose prisms, an occluder, near accommodative target, for example near fixation stick, distant target, for example most commonly a Snell's chart is utilized. In order to perform a PBCT, you must first perform a cover test as this gives an estimation of the size of the strabismus, thus an approximate starting point on the prism bar. You can also get an indication of presence and type of strabismus by observing the patient's eye and observing corneal reflections, also known as Hirschberg's. It also shows whether the patient has manifest or latent deviation. If a manifest deviation is present, it reveals which eye has the deviation or if it is alternating between both the eyes. The prism bar cover test must be conducted at near, at distance, and if necessary at greater than 6 meters. Before commencing the test, ensure the patient is sitting upright with their chin and head straight. Patient with a head tilt, abnormal head posture are not formally controlled by using a bite bar or chin rest and are always tested with their head tilt and then without their head tilt. The results leading on from the cover test will give you an indication of the type of the deviation and which way you should hold your prism for the next stage of the test, either based in for an exo deviation, base out for an ESO deviation, base up for an hypo deviation, and base down for an hyper deviation. Method. The patient should be measured in primary position first and then in any other positions of gaze of concern. For near fixation, the patient should hold an accommodative target at 33 cm. Ensuring it is in line with their visual axis. By having the patient read out loud the letters at the top of the fixation stick, it is easy to ensure they are maintaining their accommodation. The examiner then holds the prism bar over the patient's deviating eye, starting at a small strength prism. However, if the deviation on the cover test appeared to be large, a large strength prism may be used to achieve results quicker. With the prism present, an alternate cover test is performed. It is important that an alternate cover test is performed correctly in order to ensure maximum dissociation as we are determining the total deviation size, which includes both latent and manifest. It is important to ensure the patient maintains good fixation by continuing to look at the near fixation stick. As the alternate cover test is performed, the examiner watches the patient's eye for movement. If movement is seen, the prism bar is moved to increase the power. If the deviation exceeds 50 prism diopters, such that a single prism bar cannot be used, prism can either be stacked or split. Prism strength is increased until the eye under the prism produces no movement, meaning the deviation is neutralized. To confirm neutralization, the next prism of increasing strength should produce a movement in the opposite direction, indicating overcorrection. Decrease the prism strength to one level down, that is at 35 prism. This is our final PBCT for near, that is 35 prism base in. Once the result for the near PBCD have been recorded, the procedure should be repeated at 6 meter with the Snellen chart and if needed at greater than 6 meter by patient fixating out the window. Continue the test until neutralization has been established. How to record findings? The PBCD recordings assist in classification and diagnosis of specific strabismic conditions by comparing the size of the deviation from near to distance and also in other various position of gaze. When recording the results obtained on a PBCT, it must be noted. If correction, glasses or contact lenses was worn at the time of measurement, the fixation distance where the prism neutralized the deviation. That way we can gain an understanding as to whether it increases or decreases in size in different position of gaze and therefore make a diagnosis of whether it is a concomitant or incomitant deviation. The prism base utilized. For example, base in, base up, base out, or base down. The angle of deviation with the units in prism diopters, which eye is fixating and which eye is deviating. Whether the test was performed with or without an abnormal head posture. Example, PBCT with or without glasses, 35 prism base in fixing right in distance and 35 prism base in fixing right in near. If there is vertical deviation also, then PBCT with or without glasses, 35 prism base in with 6 prism R by L fixing right and 35 prism base in with 6 prism R by L fixing right. Considerations while doing PBCT. Ensure prisms are held straight. If they are held off-center, the power of the prism will not be accurate. There are two types of prisms. The first type is glass prisms, which need to be held in the prentice position, and the second type is plastic prism that need to be positioned in the frontal plane. Try to estimate the angle of deviation before placing the prism over the affected eye. This way time can be saved in busy clinics and especially with children who may have a short attention span. In larger deviations when stacking prisms over prism bar, it may be easier to place one before each eye to better observe if there is any movement taking place. The cover should be altered slowly enough to give the patient time to fixate accurately and avoid fusion by continued use of alternate cover test. To control accommodation with a fixation target, ensure it is maintained by asking the patient to identify the next letter. Indicated in patients with manifest and latent strabismus, patient with concomitant and incomitant deviation, horizontal and vertical deviations, patient with good fixation, visual acuity and cooperation. For accurate numerical recording that will provide a point of reference for future consultations, monitoring the efficacy of various non-invasive treatment and also surgery interventions. Not indicated in cyclotropias or torsional deviations, patient with eccentric fixation because the movement of the deviating eye stops when the stimulus falls on the eccentric retinal area used for fixation and not on the fovea. Patient that do not have simultaneous perception, patient that have difficulty with nystagmus, unreliable deviations greater than 80 prism diopters. Kindly subscribe the channel and press the bell icon. Thank you for watching.